Hello, everybody. Three more to go. I will try to keep everybody awake, you know, like for two more hours. Thanks so much for the introduction. Ultra Super New started officially in 2007 in Tokyo. For the people that haven't been to the office visit on Tuesday, this is how our office looks like in Harajuku. We're very proud of our Harajuku heritage. And we moved to Singapore about 4 years ago. This is the office in Singapore. And as you can see, both offices, they have a gallery as well. The gallery we're using to have a place to for young and up-and-coming emerging artists to display their work. And I got some kind of news today because we're also opening up in Taiwan right now. And that's where I want to have, you know, like a long-time dream. Oh, thank you very much. That's why I want to have, you know, like my long-time dream at the front of the agency, a noodle shop, and I want to call it Ultra Super Noodles. So this is like the mock-up. Anyway, not here to talk about us. Here to talk about why I strongly believe that creativity is the most precious thing in our industry, yeah, not technology. And I will, you know, like tell you a bit more about that. So we are now in Japan. This is, you know, like, who knows what this is, the Japanese crew? Shugatsu, you know, like when the Japanese university students, they all start to cut their hair the same way as their fathers, same suits, the girls as well, and they become very, very, very conform to go for a job interview at one of the major Japanese companies. Pretty boring and pretty sad that after, you know, like some wild university years that they are molded into, you know, like this same kind of thing. But it's actually all around us, you know, like also when you look at, you know, like any kind of like shopping mall, it all looks a little bit the same kind of brands, whether this shopping mall or this shopping mall. And, you know, like it also goes to our, you know, like the shopping malls online. So this is the biggest online retailer in Singapore called Lazada. And this is the biggest one in Japan, Rakuten. Who thinks this is awesome design? Or a little bit awesome? Or who thinks this is pretty ugly? Now, quite a lot of people, thank you. Yeah. So for me, you know, like it all becomes so blurry, you know, like when it's all this kind of messages with just, you know, like this is all this communication, but like so functional and it doesn't have any emotion or whatever. So I don't know about you, but I switch off and it all just becomes very, very, very blurry. So also, according to the lovely people of Forrester, Forrester is a global research company in marketing and in brand monitoring. And they monitor every year about 300 brands, global brands, and they monitor the consumer experience. And for four consecutive years, the consumer experience is for most of the brands is actually flatlining or actually is even going down. So there's something wrong. And I truly believe, you know, like that the major thing that is going wrong is that technology companies like Google, Apple, Facebook, Amazon, Alibaba, Line, you name it, you know, like they are, you know, like became too dominant, and that all the advertising, all the CMOs is actually, you know, like now spending all their money on them. So, you know, you get very functional and creative, very functional communication. But again, persuasion is an art. You know, like what we're doing, you know, like is not something that a robot can do, not something that AI can do, not in our lifetime. Thank God. That's why, you know, like we still have jobs. And again, to go back to the lovely people of Forrester, they agree heavily with me. Or actually, I agree with them. You know, like I don't put myself as in the same authority as them. They launched a report last year with the title "The Cost of Losing Creativity," and they basically advised the CMOs to allocate or to shift $90 billion from technology into creativity. So very, very good news for us, unless you work for Facebook, Google, or whatever. But for people such as agency people and so on, very good news for us. And what else are they advising? You know, like, what kind of solutions are they telling, you know, like, or what kind of focus points are they telling to the CMOs? A first thing, and it's all such, sounds like such a no-brainer, but, you know, like, is to create a lasting brand impression with your consumers. For example, when I opened the office in Singapore, I got to know one of the founders of Lazada, as said, one of the sort of the Amazon of Southeast Asia. And that guy said to me, like, yeah, Mark, what you're doing with your advertising and your creative stuff is not really important for us because, you know, like, we really need to have functional communication. It's performance marketing, yeah? So for us, it's all about reaching the right target group with the right banner, etc. But I told him, like, you know, like, yes, I understand, you know, like, that you think like that, but, you know, like, you don't create any kind of emotion with consumers, because what can you communicate in a banner? You know, like 50% off, 2 for 1. It's also so small, and you can just barely put some products in there. So he said, okay, Mark, you know, like, I can give you, you know, like, some budget to prove your, you know, like, your point. So he allocated $15,000 to come up with something. And we to come up with something for Mother's Day. Mother's Day is a big thing also in Singapore, where a lot of the brands are, you know, like, making all kind of communication of how much, you know, like, kids love their mother and, you know, like, that they're gonna treat their mother on a lot of presents. So we took a slightly different approach, and before showing the video, we really had to hack it together, because $15,000 is not a lot of money for a video. So the mother you're gonna see is the mother of the client, and the son is actually our junior copywriter, Ming. Hello? Yeah.
Hi, thank you so much for joining us today. How many children do you have?
Oh, I have one son. There it is.
What would you say is something you would want this Mother's Day?
What I really want for Mother's Day?
Yeah, sit down, kids. I got something to say.
Watch out. Mom and M's coming out to play.
I ain't got a lot of time. I got stuff to do. Home from work, mop the house, and cook your meals for you.
That's true.
What I'm trying to say with these rhymes I spit is that I really, really want for you to buy me shit. Buy me shit like this yoga mat.
She's a natural acrobat.
Buy me shit like this back massage.
Listen to her entourage.
Buy me shit like this bathing suit. Don't give that face, I know I look cute.
So cute.
Buy me this designer wallet.
Okay, wait, I don't think you can afford it.
Never.
I hope I'm not asking too much.
Nope.
I know that you love me and such.
Aww.
You know I still love you, it is what mothers do. Don't worry, I won't hold a grudge.
This is an emotional blackmail. Lazada is having a sale.
Oh my God,
even
really?
If I don't buy, she ain't gonna ask why this is not against my will.
Buy me shit,
be a good son.
Buy me shit,
be a good daughter.
Buy me shit,
what's the last thing?
Buy me shit,
you bought her.
Buy me shit. Buy me shit. Buy me shit.
This video became the biggest viral that year of in Singapore. Went completely to the roof, and when I saw one of the founders of Lazada, he came to me, and normally quite a stiff guy, and he hugged me and said, "Thank you, man, thank you," because his whole management was so convinced, and they were sold to Alibaba a few months later. So probably that guy is sitting right now on a tropical island counting his money. Good for him. Anyway, another thing that the Forrester people also say, you know, like, of course, you know, like, it's great to use technology. We're not against technology. You know, like, when you can use it, you know, do it. But, you know, like, do it in a smart way. This is an example of a campaign for Puma. We've been working with Puma now for quite a while. Our goal is to actually connect more to Gen Z. And through our partnership with Instagram, we came up with this campaign. Then another thing that Forrester said is attract more brand interesting prospects. For an Australian condom brand called Skin, we launched in Japan. And initially we focused on heterosexual couples, but you know, like we told Skin, you know, like, hey, you know, like there's Tokyo Gay Pride, one of the biggest prides in Asia. And how about we doing an activation there? But then, you know, like Skin said, yeah, it's great, but you know, how do you want to do it? Well, so we found this product that you're selling in the US, but not in Asia. It's called Skin Extra Loop. How about, you know, like we use that product and we're going to actually sample that at Tokyo Pride. So Skin said, okay, great, but how are you going to do that? So, well, we're going to create this booth and we're going to have condom fitting rooms. Yes. So, with the condom fitting rooms, we got this very famous gay Instagram star, and you know, like we created all kind of props and tools. This was the most popular prop, and the campaign was a huge success. People were standing in line to have their photos taken, etc. And the product was so successful in the gay community, so that Skin Condoms actually decided to launch Skin Extra Loop as an official product in Japan. So something that they never thought about, you know, it became actually now all of a sudden like a very, very big market for them. Then another thing that Forrester also says is, you know, like retain more brand loyal customers. When you just make functional and performance marketing, you know, like people just move from one place to the other because they don't really care. Loyalty is super important, especially, you know, like right now, even more and more with voice interface coming up, because you don't see all the options, you know, like when you say, like, for example, okay, Google, order me a pizza, then, you know, like, no one's beeping now, yeah. Then, you know, like, you don't want people to actually, you know, like, pay a lot of money for, you know, like, to have Domino's the first one. You want people to say, like, okay, Google, order me Domino's pizza. So anyway, for Pernod Ricard, the French alcohol company, we created a whole campaign to actually activate bartenders. Bartenders are like key gatekeepers and key promoters for drinks. And instead of, you know, like doing another bartender competition, we actually created, you know, like a bartender collaboration. So we created, you know, like we made them into the stars. They can actually, besides, you know, like curate their own cocktails, they can also curate the whole evenings. So we put that in the form of Jigger Collective. And a lot of the bartenders are not designers. So we helped them, you know, like creating all the tools. Actually, to be honest, we made all the tools for them so they can focus on what they're good at, is making cocktails. From welcome kits with a jigger in there to, so here you see the jigger, to all kind of like concepts. So this was one a concept that is executed in Shanghai, where we created, you know, like the black and white. Yeah, so again, we worked with a few bartenders. I said, okay, that sounds like a great idea. Yin and yang, black and white, dark and light, etc. So how can we make that come alive? Now, from everything from the invitations to the dress code, black and white. So they made special cocktails. We had calligraphy of the drink name to activities where we had dance performances, live calligraphy. And also the food was in tune with, you know, like the evening where we worked with all kind of chefs, etc. So a full activation and everything. So that brings me to the last point, takeaway. What I would like to advise you in order to create stuff like this is to sometimes don't look too much at the brief. To be honest, you know, like I tell the team most of the time, you know, like let's put the brief on the side, because if we're gonna make what the client wants, then, you know, like, yeah, they can better do it themselves, you know, like surprise them, you know, like think outside of the box. And there were a few presentations today, like from Vitaly and so on, where he was like focused on, like, yeah, all this boring stuff. Let's think outside of the box. Don't take things from granted, you know, like, and yeah, just try to do something different. And I think, you know, that there's an amazing crowd here of talented people, and I hope that I can actually, you know, like, stimulate you a little bit to do more crazy shit, so when I see you next year on awards, that I can also see some of your work, you know, like breaking boundaries. Thank you very much.